Hi, this is David with EdgeStar Technical Support. Today we're going to be covering two different wine cooler models. They're both thermally electric, and they're both our cold front units. One of them is an 18 bottle, and the other one is a 32 bottle. Our 18 bottle unit is the TWR-187-ESS-KF, and our 32 bottle is the TWR-327-ESS-KF. We're going to go over an introduction and basic maintenance on the units, and we'll show you how they work. All right, so here we have our two models that I was referring to here in the opening of the video. This is our TWR-187-ESS-KF. It ends with KF because it's a cold front unit. This is the sister to the EdgeStar units that you've been seeing in previous videos. So both of these are from our cold front side of the family. So this is our 187, our 18 bottle. This one is our TWR-327-ESS-KF, also a cold front 32 bottle unit. Now the only real difference between these units is their physical size. The temperature ranges, the way the control works, the type of shelves that are in the unit, everything about them are identical. This one's just a little bit taller. The 327 has a bigger compartment for white wine. So white wine enthusiasts, they love this one because they can put more whites in it. The 18 bottle, you get an equal amount of space between the two, so it's pretty well even. The controls on these are really simple. On these units, they have one added benefit that's brand new for us. The controls are actually integrated to the outside of the glass, so no more opening up the door to make your temperature adjustment. They're a lot like some of our other TWR units where the controls are actually mounted on the top of the door. On this one, they're in the middle of the door, and it's all thin film transistor stuff, so it's all brand new, and it's all right here. There's nothing clunky, there's no boxes hanging out. It looks really sleek. So on this unit we have a 10 degree temperature swing. Basically we're 55 to 65 in both zones. You can choose either or. And the same with this unit, the temperature ranges are the same. So what you would do on this unit, we have our controls. On this side you'll see a down arrow, and on this side you'll see an up arrow. So you know which control corresponds to which portion of the cabinet that we're dealing with. So our reds would typically go here, and our whites would typically go here. Same with the 18 bottle unit, you put your reds on top, your whites on the bottom. One other thing to note about these units, most of our units, when you select a temperature, you're going to see what you've selected and it will stay that way. This unit has a different feature. You will set the temperature and then it will go back to the cabinet temperature that it currently is. So eventually you'll see the temperature come down to what you've selected, or go up if you decide to go up in temperature. But after it's set the temperature that you selected in memory, it's going to go back to the current temperature real time what's in the cabinet. So, for example, to go up, and I'm working with this upper section on this side, so you can go up with it as you can see. I'm going to set it for 59, it's going to blink. It's setting it into memory. And it'll take it just a second. Now we're back at 64. Don't be confused. This is the current temperature that's inside the cabinet right now. What you've done is you've selected 59, or I did, here on the temperature. Eventually it's going to run down to 59 and we'll actually see that in the display. Same thing going the other direction as well. So, and this side here corresponds to the bottom section, and it's the same way. So remember, set your temperature, wait for it to stop blinking. It's going to go back to the normal cabinet temperature that it is right now. And then you'll eventually see it change as the temperature drops inside the cabinet. The 187 is completely identical. One other feature on these is the Talibar style handle. And you're going to see that when you open these up, and I'm going to open up this bigger one, and we'll get to the 187, I'm going to open it up in a minute. But on this one, we have our teak wood shelves. There's seven of these. It comes with your owner's manual and a set of keys. Both of these units are keyed to lock. Nice thing about that is that if you have little small children, it keeps them out of the cabinet. It'll keep an honest person out of the cabinet as well. It's just an extra bit of peace of mind for you. And these keys aren't shaped like a regular key. They have a hex head on them. So what you would do with the keys, and I'll show you how that works. So you would close the door, insert the key into the cabinet, and you're going to turn it until it locks. And as you can see, I can't really get the door open. The lock's pretty secure. To open the cabinet back up, we're going to turn it the other way, and now we're free to open up the cabinet. So both of these units have a set of keys. They come in sets of two. If for some reason you lose the keys, you can call customer service. We can order you another set. So here on the in-between, I wanted to show you the divider. This is the divider between the zones. And by the way, the unit does have whites. And I didn't show you that when I was talking about the panel. But there's our light. There's only one in these, and that's up in the top. So if you're expecting the lower zone to have a light, it doesn't. Just strictly the upper zone. Same thing with the 18 bottle unit. So on this unit, in the back also, we have a single fan for each compartment. And again, these are a dual zone unit, so you can use the reds up here and the whites down here. So let's take a look at the smaller unit. And it's pretty well the same thing. Again, we've got two teak wood shelves here and two teak wood shelves here. We have two individual fans, your keys, your owner's manual, and it does have the lock, just like the big one here, and it's pretty much the same. One other thing to note right off the bat, these units are not designed to be built in. We don't want these units in a cabinet because they can overheat and eventually they'll fail. So make sure that when you place these units in the spot where you want it, that you do it in open air. We don't want them enclosed in a cabinet of any sort. Alright, so here I wanted to show you the back of these units just to give you an overview of what's going on here in the rear. And one of the things that I'm going to cover here, and you can't really see them real well, are these little drip trays. These drip trays are at the bottom because the unit, if it's used in an area where there's moisture in the air, will collect water in the bottom of the unit, and that water has to go somewhere. So the unit has a drain system that drains that condensate water into the pan. Now normally we wouldn't see a lot, but we will see some on occasion. So about every 3 months or so, you're going to want to come back here. These catch pans are non-removable, so you want to make sure that you just wipe them out with a paper towel and you should be good to go. On the back here we have lots of ventilation on the sides, and again that goes back to the built-in warning on these units. We really don't want them built in because they do generate a lot of heat. These are actually turned on right now, and it's pretty warm coming out of here, so you want to make sure that you don't block these. These are all intake vents. This one, and this one. So the air comes in and goes out. So you need to make sure that you keep these fan vents clean. These are actually removable pre-filters. So what you're going to do is unclip them. You'll push the tab down and pull it straight out, and then pull it up to disengage it from the back of the cabinet. So you need to make sure these are washed on a regular basis, or at least vacuumed anyway. Make sure they're kept clean, and make sure that you vacuum this grill here as well as these, especially these, because that's where we're going to see a lot of our dust build up. So this one comes off the same way. It looks identical to this underneath here. So make sure that's kept clean. You can use a vacuum with a bristle brush attachment. That works great for this. Clean all of the back here, make sure that stays clean, and do all of your side vents as well. And when you're ready to put this back in, you're going to line up all these tabs here in the bottom, swing it up, and then push it in and engage the tabs, and it's back in place. So as you'll notice though, there are some differences between these. This one does not have any filters. Make sure that you clean this the same way that you would with this, with a bristle brush attachment and a vacuum. Make sure all the side vents and the back vents are kept clean. Alright, so here's a shot of both of these units with the backs opened up on them. About once every 6 months to a year, you're going to want to actually remove the backs of these units and unplug them from the wall, and take your bristle brush attachment with your vacuum and go in here and clean everything that you see. Make sure that you get as much dust out as possible. Make sure that you don't disturb any of the wiring here or the boards. Just be gentle with it, but you want to make sure it's all clean. Same on this unit. And as you can see, they're slightly different in their construction. The fans sit right on top of the cooling nodes here. But on these, they draw it in from the side. And with that bigger unit, it's got bigger openings here, and that gives it better ventilation because now we're actually directing that airflow instead of just pulling it in through the back. So This one should cool quite a bit better than some of the other units that are out there today. This unit here, the smaller one, doesn't need as much airflow, so we don't require the way the different fans are set up on it and the way it's set up to draw the air in. So just make sure, and while you're back here, you can clean the other vents, the side vents, from the inside. Just make sure you get them from both sides and put your backpack on. And you might want to take a damp rag and just kind of wipe these fan blades down a little bit. Just make sure it's clean, that way we have good airflow. Then you can put the backpack on. Alright, so one last thing I wanted to show you here is I wanted to show you the adjustable feet. Now again, on these units are identical, they're just physically bigger in size. We have three big feet and one small adjustable foot here in the front. And the fixed feet don't ever really get moved. So you need to make sure that wherever you set these units at, that they're basically level to begin with, and you're just going to kind of keep it from wobbling. So as you can see here, we have one foot that's a lot smaller than the rest of them. And I'm going to take that out and show you. And as you can see, it's got a really short shank on it. Well, it's a lot smaller than these, as you can see. So the reason it's smaller than these, because you would think you'd have four big legs, is because this hinge takes up the room that these big legs have over here. So we had to shrink the leg to make it work. So typically you'll find this already attached to the unit. Most of the time that's the case. Occasionally you'll find where it's dropped off inside the packaging. Make sure you check your packaging. Make sure you check the inside of the unit if you don't see it. If for some reason that it's just gone, it's not there, then you can call customer service and we'll go ahead and get another leg ordered for you so that you can have that. So again, these are fixed. This one is adjustable. And this screws into the lower hinge, not the body of the cooler. One other thing I want to cover here as well. And you see this T-shaped latch, that's part of the lock. If for some reason you lose your key, you don't have it, you can still get in here. If you take these two screws out, you can drop this lock plate off and the door will open up. And sometimes, every once in a while, we'll see a unit where the key has got locked into it. And that's very seldom that we see that, but we get an occasional report of it. What you'll need to do is take these two screws out, drop this lock plate off, then you can get inside the unit and get the keys. You're going to put this lock plate back on, and then you need to lock the door and make sure that the tang goes through this big slot so it locks it up. I hope that this do-it-yourself video has helped you to familiarize and set up your new 18 bottle and 32 bottle wine coolers, the TWR 187 ESSKF and the TWR 327 ESSKF. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact EdStar at www.edstar.com.